Hello everyone, you are listening to this audiobook on channel Voice of Purpose by NSS IIT Bombay.
Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, Chapter 2. The Evil Stepmother. After a year had passed, the king took to himself another wife. She was a beautiful woman, but proud and haughty, and she could not bear that anyone else should surpass her in beauty. She had a wonderful looking glass, and when she stood in front of it and looked at herself in it and said, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who in this land is the fairest of all?" The looking glass answered, "Thou, O queen, art the fairest of all." Then she was satisfied, for she knew that the mirror spoke the truth. But Snow White was growing up and grew more and more beautiful. And when she was 7 years old, she was as beautiful as the day and more beautiful than the queen herself. And once when the queen asked her looking glass, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who in this land is the fairest of all?" it answered, "Thou art fairer than all who are here, Lady Queen, but more beautiful still is Snow White, as I ween." Then the queen was shocked and turned yellow and green with envy. From that hour, whenever she looked at Snow White, her heart heaved in her breast. She hated the girl so much, and envy and pride grew higher and higher in her heart like a weed, so that she had no peace day or night. She called a huntsman and said, "Take the child away into the forest. I will no longer have her in my sight. Kill her and bring me back her lung and liver as a token." The huntsman obeyed and took her away. But when he had drawn his knife and was about to pierce Snow White's innocent heart, she began to weep and said, "Ah, dear huntsman, leave me my life. I'll run away into the wild forest and never come home again." And as she was so beautiful, the huntsman had pity on her and said, "Run away then, you poor child. The wild beast will soon have devoured you," thought he. And yet it seemed as if a stone had been rolled from his heart, since it was no longer needful for him to kill her. And as a young bear just then came running by, he stabbed it, and cut out his lung and liver, and took them to the queen, as proof that the child was dead. The cook had to salt them, and the wicked queen ate them, and thought she had eaten the lung and liver of Snow White.
So hope you guys had fun. Please like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more interesting audiobooks.